and welcome to Comedy Tonight.
We're all super excited to have you here.
We know you all have better things to be doing, but...
Nothing as good as this, am I right?
Yeah, sure. Anyway...
Come on, Molly, yeah, it's gonna be so much fun!
Never said it wasn't.
There's so many great things coming up.
Yep.
You're gonna be playing a certain peppy, fun-loving faculty member.
Yeah, no, anyway.
And there's going to be a dance number to a song by a certain pop star who got a drastic haircut back in 2007. Oh, and there's going to be a nature documentary, and aliens are gonna be coming.
Right. Now, without giving anything else away, you're in for a great show tonight.
Yeah, definitely, especially that
dance. Let's save something for later. Now for some necessary information. There will be a 10-minute intermission halfway through the show.
Please hold back your tears. I know I am.
There are two emergency exits in the black box, located here and there. And now for the rules.
I'd like to call them obligatory suggestions.
Please do not use your cell phones during the show.
And that means no checking Facebook or scrolling through your Instagram feed or sending out Snapchats.
Just nothing. If you like the show that much and want to share it, you should bring all of your friends tomorrow.
And also, please no flash photography. Sorry, I know we're pretty, but light really washes me out, you know?
Speaking of distractions, it would be greatly appreciated. The actors, they're very sensitive. So please no overly distracting, obnoxious noises in the order.
Anyways, we all hope you have a great night.
Don't forget to laugh.
Yeah,
she's
a
good
pair. maybe we'll just go with figures with Alexander Hamilton and Jesus?
That's right, my baby loves the creator.
Alright, well, next is Tammy Clinton. She is a 17-year-old freshman from Lincoln High in Washington, D.C. She lives with her parents. Her talent was being able to count backwards while her eyes were closed.
Isn't she cute? Even more so when she is immobile. Excuse me, that was my polite way of saying go back to your spot. Go back! You're taking up the spotlight.
Penelope's parents are both former heads of state, and her mom, Hillary, is now running for president. Now next up is Penelope Trump. She is a 15-year-old sophomore. Once on this island, which was her school news for us?
I want to be where the people are. I want to see them dead.
Oh, the horrors of Walt Disney! Please, I'm not Children's Day!
What's that? Penelope's father, Donald Trump, is also running for president for 2016.
That's right! Now breathe a beautiful war on this beautiful country!
Biology. I love hearing about how God created the world in 7 days.
Here's your question, Gail. The way that women are portrayed in the film industry is an important issue that many people... Oh, never mind that question, Gail. George just informed me. You're actually from an extremely religious family that forbids most electronic appliances. Let me just find another one. How about who is your role model and why?
Jesus is my role model in my eye. He gave up his life to save me and made many promises to me, such as allowing my little dog Toto into heaven, even though all he did was eat people food from the table and poo-poo all over the carpet. Bless you all. Amen.
Back to you, Jamie.
Follow the audience with your eyes. Win them over with your eyes.
Shut up! Who likes you? You're old.
Tell us a little bit about your passions.
My greatest interest is serial killers. I think they're really fascinating and quite insightful on the wonders of the world. I'm actually really knowledgeable on the subject and have even been sent to the guidance counselor a few times because I wrote reports that were so accurate. Remember, Dad? Remember when I got sent to the guidance counselor? I hope to meet one someday.
Be gone, Satan!
That's really good news, so let's move on. Penny has to answer a question now. Fun fact, everyone, Penny's dream job is to be a princess. Now, here's the question. What's your favorite animal?
Unicorns!
But they aren't even real!
Says no one ever!
Says everyone!
Okay, Penelope, can't tell this lie, okay? They're real as Peter Pan and the fairies.
And say hi, guys, girls! Penelope, you are up next. How would you solve the problem of global warming?
Are you kidding? That's my question?
If you don't like it, you can always be disqualified.
People need to limit the amount of harmful gases in the atmosphere. However, since companies have clearly shown that they value profit over safety, it will take the work of individual governments to help make these changes. It will also take them working together, like in the United Nations.
Good answer.
Excuse me, but global warming isn't real. It's just those who just feel the heat of hell.
All right. Well, now it's Gail's turn. Fun fact. Now, Gail, what's the first thing you would do once you became Miss Teen Girl?
I would go on the parade float the winter rides on and sing gospel songs with my friends, the entire nunnery of St. Agatha's Church. And then we go door to door and try to bring those heathens back with God's graces. Bless you all, and amen.
That's
nothing. That wasn't real.
Great job to give all of our contestants. Thank you all for participating. Now me and George.
George and I.
Whatever. We will now take a moment to decide on the winner. We'll be right back.
We better be Penelope, okay?
Shut it, Donald.
Did you know that 6,000 people were kidnapped last year? Would you like to
do
Don't
push
up! become the president. I'm going to come here to walk off. You're going to be leading all these Mexican killers.
Just pay for everything.
Yes.
Pay for everything.
Okay, calm down. Now, don't worry. I will buy a new one for you. Better than anyone. It's going to be Louis Millions because I have feelings.
Don't worry, Gail. God will just pray even harder, and next year God will punish them.
With guns and germs and spears.
Cheshire's. Previous episodes have observed behavior at the watering hole, known colloquially as Starbucks, and at the gladiatorial arena, usually referred to as prom. Today we'll be looking at Studentius Academicus, more commonly known as the high school student. A fascinating organism. The high school student can be found on almost every continent in a variety of different ecosystems. Much like the domesticated dog or house cat, there's a variety of different subspecies within this group, and today we'll be closely examining these incredible creatures. Here, we see a particularly interesting dynamic, the male and the female of the species interacting. Let's observe and see what we can glean from their behavior.
The test isn't going to be that hard. It's just on chapter 6 and chapter 7. We have all our notes from the chapter that we took. We have all our homeworks handed back and graded, and we have that quiz. And a study guide. If A shouldn't be that hard.
I must have lost my notes somewhere. Thanks for helping me again, Mandy. You always do so well on these quizzes and tests. And my parents tell me I can't get my driver's license until I get at least a B-.
Oh, that's okay. I'll get it. Here is chapter 6. And here is chapter 7.
This is going to be hard.
There are two distinct levels of interaction here. As the student is academically grows older, they are subjected to difficult challenges as presented by the environment. These challenges usually take the form of tests that the student is analogous is required to pass in order to remain a member of the pack. In this case, a literal test. That is the first level of interaction between the male and female. Preparing for these tests. The second is part of an extended dating ritual, which they might not even be aware of. Their developing brains overwhelmed with hormones. They start to each other in ways that they might not even register, but are nonetheless taking place. Observe how the male has positioned himself closer to the female, so they can both share the reading material. She appears closer to attention. He does not appear aware of his impact on her, though it is clear that her ability to focus has been hindered by his close proximity. Here we see another set of studentius adolescentes. They appear to be engaging in some sort of team-building exercise, strengthening bonds and developing skills that will help them later on in life.
When all of a sudden the party is ambushed by a group of goblins, roll a 20-sided die for initiative. The higher the number, the higher in the order you will go.
17. Ooh. 19. Yep.
2. 20-sided dice, and I get a 2. How can I be this bad at rolling? Based on statistics, shouldn't I eventually get a decent roll?
Guess not! Bundle the Dwarven Warrior catches an arrow to his shield and takes no damage.
Ooh, take that, Goblin Scum!
Theon and the Elven Rogue basically somersaults away from the arrow that flies through the air when he was just a second ago.
Nice! Can't touch us!
Darnell, the human wizard, trips on the roof, falls on his face, and takes an arrow in the back.
Again? That's the third character I've lost this week. There must be some kind of class I can take on dice rolling. I don't think we've gotten higher than a 10 this whole campaign.
Fascinating. Communication, planning, and dexterity are all skills that Studentius Adventius require later in life, and this activity apparently helps them develop those. Observe how the one in charge has placed a screen of some kind to keep the mystery up for her fellows. Two appear to be happy with the results, while the third one seems rather crestfallen.
Yo, I couldn't believe how open they left me. Like, I had already scored 3 times that quarter, and they weren't even gonna cover me. No wonder we're undefeated, and they haven't won a game yet. I grab the ball, back down their center, and do the little sky hook. Coach says my soft hands are gonna be what colleges are looking for most.
Dude.
single year. Of course, I'm still waiting to hear back from UConn, which would obviously be my first choice. Just depends on whether or not I can impress Gino Ariana at our private workout later this month.
I've got a recruiter to LSU and Boston College, but I'm leaning towards Boston College because they have a history of getting linebackers to the pros, you know what I'm saying? And I'd probably like to play this year, whereas if I went to LSU, I wouldn't play unless one of their guys got injured. In the ACC, I'd look like a beast, but in the SEC, everyone's a beast.
Well, still, those are some great options. I've got a rise to neither North Dakota or Providence College. Well, North Dakota has a better team, but it's in North Dakota. I've only spent 4 years of my life in this absolute middle of nowhere. Well, both of them have been in closing war recently. Both of them have great coaches, but it kind of depends who else is on that team.
Yes. These three student disadvantages are prime examples of physical potential in the speaking. And the five, each of them has developed a specific skill and has worked hard to improve it. And the pack has taken notice. Pack leaders of other packs are eager to recruit them. As the student disadvantages moves to the next stage of their life, student is collegiate, they are forced to move into a new pack and become one with that group dynamic. With their skills and hard work, these three student advantages will be highly sought after by other pack leaders. Moving along, we see three younger student advantages, anxiously waiting for someone or something. Observe their movements, jerkier, the voices higher than usual. Ah, here comes the teacher's academics now.
I'm surprised to see so many kids in my room trying extra help. Usually it's deserted.
That's not true. I am here all the time. All right, most of the time. Some of the time. Occasionally.
Are we gonna have a pop quiz tomorrow?
Yeah, what's the quiz gonna be on?
We may have a pop quiz, and we may not. If I told you, it would be a pop quiz. I might as well just put it on the portal ahead of time. The purpose of a pop quiz is to reward the students who did the reading and to act as a reminder of the importance of homework for those who did it. It gives me a way to measure who's paying attention to reading the chapter.
So there is going to be a pop quiz. She's just trying to trick us. If she makes us think that there's going to be a pop quiz, we'll pay more attention to the reading and she won't even give it to us.
Well, I've done the leading for nothing!
Really?
I enjoy leading so much!
You didn't answer our question! Will there be a pop quiz or not?
Do the homework and take notes as if there will be a pop quiz. And that way you'll be super prepared for one if there is, or you can be a great contributor, or even a leader in class if there is.
But the teacher's academics' role within the pack is to transmit information to the younger generation. If the teacher's academics is unsuccessful in her task, she could lose her habitat and even her source of nourishment. The pack has no place for ineffective teacher's academics. It's unclear whether these three younger student's allergies will earn high marks in the eyes of the pack. Sometimes the anxiety drives their ability to succeed, while other times hinders their ability to learn in the most effective manner. It is clear from what we've seen that there is a wide variety of student disadvantages and how their many adaptations allow them to live in so many disparate environments. Next week's episode will be the season finale, an hour-long in-depth look at an event known as the SAT, for suffering all the time.
I don't know how we're gonna follow that, which is so good. You know what we could do?
No.
We could.
No.
Do a...
No.
Dance number.
Well, I'm not gonna dance.
I think it'd be great.
But luckily for you, we have a CA dance team here tonight to do a performance for us.
Don't take the barbie car! Monopoly money!
Oh my god!
those pills in front of us.
What seems to be the problem here?
Your staff is giving me the paper that I won't be able to use.
Do you need money? Can I see what they give you? Sir, I'd like to assure you this money is 100% real. And I don't appreciate that you're making such a big deal of it in my bank.
Oh, you people in this bank are crazy. This is not real money. This is monopoly money used to pay the mortgage, and it does not have any real value. Fine, you know what? If you people say it is real, then it should work at other places, right? God, everyone these days are getting so much more stupider. I swear, this is not real money, right? Well, if they say it's real money, then I should be able to use it at McDonald's, right? Oh, and I can probably pay for a freaking tow truck to get my scooter out. That piece of junk. Okay, let's try that.
Ah, yes, you are back again.
Yes. Hello, Miss.
Yes, you are.
I would like to pay for those cash jobs.
Okay.
Here's.
Okay, well, sir, this is not real money. This is monopoly money. You can see the word monopoly.
Why don't you tell that to the bank across the street?
What?
Just never mind.
But it's pink.
You're pink. I assure you, that is real money. I just pulled it out of my savings.
I'm sorry, but sir, I cannot accept this. This is not real money. My boss will fire me if I do.
Boss? Oh, crap. I'm late for work. Just keep the chain, okay? I apologize. Ah, yes, can I get, my scooter seems to have run out of gas or something. Can I get a tow to an auto body repair shop? You would? Yeah, thanks. Route 14, McDonald's. Thank you. What am I gonna do now? I don't have any money right now, and I can't pay for those hash browns. Oh, maybe I can pay for a cab with all this money I have. Oh wait, it's not real. Maybe my friend Jerry will pick me up. He's about to do something nice for me anyway, right? Hey, Jerry. Yeah, can you pick me up to go to work? You would? Yeah, thanks. Yeah, Route 14. I'm at McDonald's. Thank you. Oh, where's the phone truck?
What can I do for you today, sir?
Oh, I don't know. All I want is money to pay for my hash browns and then go to work. But everyone today seems so outrageous and has no consideration for others.
I don't think I can help you with that. Is there anything else you'd like me?
I'm just kidding. All I need you to do is tow away my scooter, and that is your job, right?
Hey, I'm just trying to help out. You know what I mean?
Fine. I'll pay you later. She forgot my scooter! Hello?
Hi, dear.
Pierre, explain me why you're late!
Again. This is the third time of the week. Yeah.
It's a long story, and I don't think you'll live to hear it.
Oh, yes, yes. I'm your boss! I deserve explanation, right? So explain me why I'm late.
Okay. But I warned you. First, I went to go to work. But then, I wanted the Barbie car. But my wife is stronger than me. So, I decided to go use the scooter. And then all of a sudden, a bird hit me. It died. So I decided to go to McDonald's afterwards, and I decided to get an egg muffin. but they ran out, so I decided to get hash browns instead. But my car didn't work, and so I went to the bank across the street, but they gave me monopoly money instead.
Stop here. What kind of bank will give their customers monopoly money?
I know, right?
Yeah, I see here, huh? Joking with me, huh? Tell me the truth or you're fired.
Wait, what?
Tell me the truth or you're fired.
Wait, but...
But what?
That was the truth.
Okay, I see. If you're gonna keep it that way, then you're fired.
What?
Do you want me to spell out for you? You are F-I-R-E-D. You're fired. Goodbye.
Huh? Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
Come on!
No need to.
Why not?
I'd rather not talk about it.
I'm walking on sunshine.
Celebrated heads of state or specially great communicators.
Hello. Matt, you are all wondering why I brought you all here.
Well, one of you stole my ramen noodles!
Get this idiot out of here!
But I have a perfect reason being here!
Yeah, and all of it will water tomorrow. Girls, get this loser off my stage!
Ramen noodles, no!
OMG, like this loser again?
Oh my god, like, can you not even miss me?
Like, I can't even.
My ramen noodles, please. No, no, no. No, mercy! No!
Hello! I bet you're all wondering why I brought you here tonight. Well, it's for a game show! I'm your host! Hosty McHostington!
Oh, sorry, are we going live?
Yeah. I'm Sammy Johnson, Hosty's life partner and your other host! And this is Couples Contest, the new hottest game show around. But first, we'd like to thank our sponsors, Shakeweight! Shakeweight right over your hard earned cash, right out of your hands and into our pockets. Buy it right now, but not until after you've watched our three couples face off. This is episode 6. We'll be testing our couples in life skills. Here they come, now! Here they come, now! Go get that!
Oh my, damn it! Oh my god, like Dave, are you like okay?
Sure, whatever. I don't even know why I agreed to go on this stupid show in the first place. I guess that shows something about it.
Here's our first couple now, Cynical Dave and Lily.
Hey, Caitlin, is it taco day at the place across the street?
Like, Joey, we're on the show. Like, get it together.
Probably get a sandwich after this. I'm good for me.
Where's the next one?
Sammy, like, I'm so sorry. I can't, like, find him.
It's okay, Brittany. Just go on without it.
It's Thomas. John Thomas.
But John, what are you doing there?
I promise you that this won't take long. This is Agent 324-1969.
We've got
34-44-54.
Are you kidding
me? I'm almost bloody done here. 1989, 2004, 5555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555555
sweet. I guess you'd say his days on the show are numbered.
Oh. Like, you think you have a bad?
Nah.
As I was saying, the three couples will be participating in a contest of life skills today. In this contest, each couple will be judged on how well, or rather how badly, each couple performs. These three phones are all locked with the password. You'll be scored based on how quickly you can hack or otherwise reach the home screen.
But this is an iPhone! You're all so phony!
Oh. If you and your significant other both suck at the challenge, then that sucks. Get started!
Like, John, do you not like that? John?
All suck at this. I'll just give you the password.
password is 1234. And I'll just give the point to Cynical Dave and Lily. They tried.
Seriously? What? Seriously? What? This is ridiculous.
Stop complaining. You won.
Oh my god, we're all like so stupid.
Yes. Yes, you are. Moving on to the next challenge. These are tax forms. Do them.
And how in the places are we like supposed to do that?
Am I like supposed to know? I got a D in algebra 2.
OMG, hashtag twinsies.
I got a Greek B in pre-calc. Maybe I can use that quadratic formula.
Actually, you can't.
What? But then why'd I learn it?
How should I know? It's completely useless. All you can do with it is study. And cry. They're not supposed to know that. Face Get Clean, our newest product for getting the crap off of your face.
facial pain. One person had a stroke during testing. In extreme cases, side effects could also include suicidal thoughts and behavior, complete paralysis, kidney failure, or instant death. Go to www.facegetclean.com or dial 1-800. Yes, sir. Get your bottle of Face Get Clean for only $19.99. Face Get Clean, get the crap out of your face.
That was a good commercial.
Do you think anybody's gonna actually buy our product?
As we might find out, we're full of crap.
I would tell you no, but then I realized how easy it is to sell a useless product.
What should we do for the next challenge?
You can have them fix chairs or something. I don't really share at all.
Oh.
Alright. Live in three.
Live in three.
With cynical Dave and Lily, tied just Brittany, contestants are neck and neck, except for Joe and Caitlin, who are dragging in the dust behind them.
Did someone say my name?
Like, yeah, you big dummy.
In the third challenge, you'll fix some chairs. But wait, don't get too excited, because there is a twist. You've got no tape and no YouTube.
No YouTube? But then how are we, like, supposed to fix it at all?
I don't know, figure it out.
What are we supposed to do? Lick them till they actually get better?
Woo! Figure it out.
What? Why do you always hate me?
Okay. Our chair isn't even broken.
Or you and Lily will get sent home.
I honestly don't see a problem with that.
Well.
Fine.
This is such a mess.
I can't even think remarks cynical enough to do that disaster justice.
How? The chair is basically unusable.
Can we just score right now? It wouldn't do much better if we made them an hour.
Oh my God.
walks, the paragon of monogamy. Hi, I am zoologist and anthropologist David Antebrock. I have brought you such wildlife documentaries as Planet Earth, The Song of the Earth, The State of the Earth, Life of Plants on Earth, and Earthy Earth Earth. Historia of the Earth. Today I bring you the life of birds on Earth. Swans pair up in their youth and mate for life. They forage together, groom each other, engage in mating dance rituals, and mate for life. As you can see, the other mate does not interest the swan. He only has eyes for his one true love.
Bewitched?
Bewitched?
Engaged in a procreative
interpretations or perception of the natural order of things on planet Earth.
David, you are deriving an ox from what an is, just because that we, the paragon of all animals, as Shakespeare once put it, should not descend to the level of lowly beasts. You are subscribing to naturalistic behaviors or ethics, a system of ethics that have been deemed invalid time after time.
You know, Justin Bieber once told People magazine that he questioned whether or not humans are meant to be monogamous.
So now you're using Justin Bieber and swans to conquer moral compass?
How logically.
You know, let's just put this all aside and go relax in the hot tub, shall we?
Okay.
Interesting. Very interesting. He was a monogamous after all.
Okay.
In David's defense, I'm not even that attracted to human beings, but I want her. She was, as the humans might say, a total smoke show. She was super hot. It's no wonder that such a steady delight would confuse the humans.
Poor, ignorant, lustful humans. They don't understand what we, the wisest creatures in the multiverse, have learned. But monogamy gives rise to the noblest of achievements. World peace, the eradication of hunger, and the end of STDs.
Yeah, but did you see her?
I can't even hold someone's friendship for more than 2 minutes. If anyone knows that I have feelings for them, they immediately want to cut off all contact with me. Like I have Ebola or something.
Ah, here we go. We often see girls being mercilessly heartbroken by their boyfriends in films and television. But where's the story of the girl who loses the guy's friendship before they even have a chance at love? Here are 13 ways to make someone of the opposite sex never want to speak to you again, even though they're super awesome. 1. Memorize their class schedule so you can brighten up their day with surprises.
Okay. Oh, maybe I'm warning. Hey.
Hi.
What are you doing here?
Just, you know, it's a visit my favorite teacher.
Okay, but Miss Quino is not here.
I know, right?
Okay. Where is Miss Quino? Miss Quino!
I'm so done with you. You're gross. You look gross. And like, you're just bad. You're bad. And you know what? I actually care for you. I thought you were a great friend, but you're not. And like, you can tell your best friend, tell your other best friend, tell the whole entire world for all I care. Awesome sauce.
Number 6. Ask them to buy avocados. How romantic!
We need to go buy avocados at the coffee shop.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
I don't like avocados.
Yeah, you do. Everyone likes avocados. You don't like avocados. You like avocados.
No, I don't.
Yeah, you do.
No, I don't like avocados.
It's a lie.
No, it's not.
Why can't we just go buy some avocados?
Because I don't want to.
Number 8. Get justifiably angry at them on social media because the frustration is so real.
Like, just my whole entire life. Why are you like this? comedic, you know? I know.
Sure.
I'm a sleeper.
of many things. I come in at 8:11, and he smiles and says, "How are you?" He smiles and says, "How are you?" I could swear my heart grows wings. So today at 8:11, I decided I should meet him. I decided I should meet him in a proper, formal way. So today at 8:11, when he smiled and said, "How are you?" I said, "Fine, and my name's Sam." And he softly answered, "Hey." And I said, "My name's Sarah. And thank you for the extra form." And he said his name was John Jay, which provides the inspiration for this poem. John Jay, the latte boy, bring me Java, bring me joy. Oh, John Jay, I love him, I love him. So I'd like to get my nerve up to recite my poem musical. He would like the fact it's musical because he plays guitar. So today at 8:11, John Jing told me he was playing in a band down at the academy in the upstairs of the field house. And he smoothly flipped the lever to prepare my double latte. But for me, he made it triple, and he didn't think I knew. But I saw him flip the lever, and for me, he made it triple. And I knew that triple latte meant that Taylor loved me too. I said, "What time are you playing? And thank you for the extra skill." He said, "Keep the 3:55, because this triple latte was on him." John Jay, the latte boy, bring me Java, bring me joy. Oh, John Jay, the latte boy, I love him, I love him, I love him. I used to be the kind of girl who'd run when love assured her. Step up to the counter and order. John Jay, the latte boy, bring me Java, bring me joy. Oh, John Jay, the latte boy, I love him, I love him, I love him. So many years my heart has waited. Who'd have thought that love be so caffeinated? John Jay, the latte boy, I love him, I love him, I love him. I love him, I love him, I love him.
That's too big to ignore. She comes in here every morning at exactly 8:11. When the clock says 8:11, she comes walking through the door. And that one fateful morning, as she made her your own entrance, I could tell that she was nervous and she had something to say. So I smoothly flapped the lever to prepare her double latte. She said her name was Sam, and I came back with "Hey." And I said my name was John Jen, and here's a little extra form. As she left, I cleaned her table, and I found a folded napkin with his poem.
I love him, I
interested. Well, see, she was really interested. It's all gone out of hand. So before I found her home, we had this conversation where I told her I was playing in the theater with my friends. When I'm walking Friday evening to our school little black box, I saw Sam in the front row and I heard her scream my name.
John James!
And Miss Greeno said, man, she's crazy! Been here since 7:30 and she told me she's your girlfriend. She's really glad she came. And when our show was over, she followed me the whole way home. As I ran to try to lose her, I composed another version of her poem. Sam, the stalker chick. You are psycho and you're sick. A stalker chick. You scare me. I used to be the kind of guy who never was rude or doubting. But now I've got this lunatic freak in my life. Every night at my window she's shouting. Changing. So latte boy, go home girl, I'm not your toy. Oh, Changing, the latte boy is calling the police. Many a girl has let me court her, but I never needed a restraining order. Come find me now, I'm transferring to a new Starbucks. There's 20 on each block, so good luck.
Ah! club. Starting next week, I will.
You know what? No, we're not. Not until you put some closed-toed shoes on. We all know, since we have read our Cheshire Academy handbook, that open-toed shoes are not a condoned choice at the academy.
That's right.
I have even sent my own sons home. In my house in Maine, my sister.
Miss McGree, we're gonna have to cut you off right there.
Okay, take it easy.
Thank you.
Can I have it?
Now, Miss West.
Gluten. I hope you enjoyed our ride, cause it's a real big waste of our time. While driving back from the soccer game eating bagels.
Where?
Goodbye. How can you think about leaving? Get those thoughts out of your head.
be together, it's too late to turn back.
Dessert and drinks, so we should all go away and enjoy that. That's all. Thank you.